What's good, TMG fam? It's your boy Ellen. I'm back with another reaction. How y'all feel? Welcome back to the channel. Salute. So, for the third time, I'm trying to record this video, this reaction, man. Every time I get started, something happens. It's almost kind of starting to feel like something's like they don't want me to get this video out for some strange reason. I don't know. That's what I'm starting to think. But this video is the top 10 terrifying government secrets that Edward Snowden revealed. Meaning he already revealed. So me just reacting to the video, y'all ain't gotta stop me, man. It's just little old me, bro. I keep trying. I keep getting shut down. The internet keeps stopping. Different things keep happening. And I'm like, I'm kind of side-eyeing. Like, are they trying to stop me from reacting to this video? But nah. Yeah, we're going to get into some of these secrets, man. Secrets revealed. So I know a lot of you guys get into stuff like this. Some of you are maybe a little extra paranoid, more paranoid than the rest of us. Some of us are a little paranoid. Some of us, y'all are like high alert paranoia. It's crazy. You go to your house, you got like all the cameras in your house. You got tape over them or you got something in front of it. So you feel like something's watching you. You got newspaper all over your windows and stuff like that. You're trying to. I get it. Calm down. Just breathe. Okay? Just breathe. All right, so we're going to get into this video, man. Real quick, if you are new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. Also, look in the description, man. Me and Queen, we've been going hard on the other channel, man. Be having these late night discussions and just some laughs, man, for you to come kick back. So make sure you hit that link up to the new channel, Just the Tip, in the description. All right, and come join me real quick. Everybody, I need everybody. Everybody, come on. Moment of silence for the haters. Everybody do it, all right? Here we go, moment of silence for the haters. That's enough. Now run the likes up. Let's get to it.
On June 6th, 2013, the internet erupted when The Guardian reported that the NSA had secretly been collecting phone records from millions of Verizon customers.
And then just 3 days later, on June 9th, quick math, Edward Snowden came out and admitted that he was the source of said leak. But what exactly did he uncover?
Welcome back, Most Amazing Family. For today's list, you might want to set those browsers to incognito. I'm one of your hosts, Olivia Kozlowski.
And I'm Taylor McWaters, and here are the top 10 terrifying government secrets that Edward Snowden...
I remember when stuff like that had come out, man. Everybody was kind of divided. Some people were like, oh my gosh, this is going on. Some people was like, we already knew, we know. We kind of figured this. We've been trying to tell y'all. It was like a divide, man.
Revealed.
Starting off this list in our number 10 spot, we have SIM cards. We see all the time in movies and shows when people are trying to be super secret, they smash their phone and their SIM card. But as it turns out, maybe we should all be smashing our SIM cards, super secret lifestyle or not. In February of 2015, it was reported that Snowden provided documents that showed that the NSA and GCHQ had hacked into a Dutch company that is responsible for manufacturing and supplying 2 billion SIM cards per year, and they supply places like AT&T, Verizon, T-Mobile, and a variety of other providers. While this hack would suggest that the agencies would then now have access to billions of unique encryption keys, which could potentially allow them to bypass wireless providers and monitor both voice and data transmissions of every user that has a SIM card made by this company. The company did reply to the situation and said that they had been the target of at least 2, quote, particularly sophisticated intrusions, and they suggested that they believed that the NSA and the GCHQ were responsible, but the company then denied that the hack was successful in gaining access to those encryption keys.
See, man? And see, I used to run around and think, yo, these SIM cards, I used to think these SIM cards were like little tracking devices. You know what I mean? Oh my gosh. They got tracking devices on us, man. These SIM cards, it's there. I was just like screaming to the top of my lungs telling people, man, yo, these SIM cards, that's how they tracking us. That was back before your phone was actual. Now it's just like a blatant app on your phone where it tracks you. So, you know, they're able to monitor it too. So that's what I'd be thinking. But I was saying that before. And then the whole records thing, you know, you see on movies and different things like that, or you watch shows and you see that normally it's kind of like a subpoena that has to go to these phone companies to be able to get the information in their records, to be able to put a wiretap on something like that. But now they're saying these companies using those SIM cards could just bypass that and go straight through. That's scary. That scared.
Number 9, quantum computer. This next one is eye-opening, to say the least. Computers are getting more and more advanced by the day. Deepfakes are going to ruin my life. They're getting really good at those. I feel like an old man every time I see those and fall for it. But thanks to our man Snowden, it was reported in the Washington Post on January 2nd, 2014, that the NSA is working hard at creating their own computer. How fun must that be? It's called the quantum computer, and it cost about $80 million to create. And no, it can't send you back in time. This computer is safely stored in a massive room-sized metal box, which is not intimidating at all, and it's part of a program called Penetrating Hard Targets. I want to make so many jokes, but I won't. So it can break encryptions for just about anything. Finance records, medical, your old MSN, probably. What a nightmare that would be. The NSA is well on their way to breaking every form of public encryption. This quantum computer can theoretically break through any RSA encryption, which for the average computer today, that takes, I don't know, years, but this supercomputer can break through a lot faster. I'm talking days. Just don't go in my MSN, please.
In our number 8 spot today, we have Project Dishfire. It was reported by The Guardian that it had been revealed that the NSA collects 200 million text messages a day from around the world. They then use these messages to pull the details of certain location information, contact networks, and the credit card details of different mobile users.
See, I believe that as well, too. And trigger words, like words that you type or say into your phone, I believe it goes somewhere and it like picks up, it flags you. You know what I mean? So if you say certain words, I ain't finna say them on here because I ain't trying to be flagged. And you be like, but you're not on your phone. How often do you say something or have a conversation around your phone and then you go to get on your phone and you start seeing ads for everything you just talked about? You haven't typed anything in your phone you was just talking about. But next thing you know, you get on social media and maybe it's Facebook, maybe it's Instagram, and you start seeing different advertisements for the same thing you was just speaking on. So, yeah, it's like that, fam. It's like that out here. But yeah, I definitely believe in those trigger words, too, that get you flagged.
It was also reported that the NSA also provided British intelligence agencies with all of the data, just without the actual context of the text messages. So the NSA has all your secrets and nudies, but at least they didn't share them? I don't know. Basically, they have all of this data and at any point could potentially extract certain information like past travel plans, your financial transactions, your contacts, regardless of whether or not you were being investigated for something. Yes, this sounds illegal, unethical, and a little shady, and this revelation all came before former President Barack Obama gave a speech about proposed policy changes in reaction to the whistleblowing that was going on around Snowden and the NSA.
Number 7, friends without benefits. Even allies of the United States are not safe here. Thanks to Snowden, at the end of October 2013, it was leaked that the states were spying on Germany, France, and Spain. The NSA had tapped into 35 phones, which, by the way, not just a couple of random dudes, they were spying on 35 world leaders. One of which was German Chancellor Angela Merkel, who called out the NSA after finding out, of course, and said this act of snooping was just unacceptable between friends. Really went personal with the friends comment there. It's like when you show somebody a photo on your phone and they start swiping, like, hi, hello, betrayal, see ya. Now, as you hear this, you're thinking, well, I'm not a world leader, what's the big deal here? Well, it was also reported that the NSA was monitoring phone calls in Spain for the average folk. They monitored about 60 million calls in 1 month. So yeah, world leader or not, be a little concerned about these guys, maybe.
In our number 6 spot today, we have the Brazil spying scandal. It was reported by The Guardian that Brazil was second only to the United States in terms of the amount of communications that were being subjected to surveillance by the NSA. This means that the NSA were seriously spying on millions of Brazilians, including the emails and phone calls of their president. At the G20 summit that year, which took place in Russia, Brazil's president at the time, Dilma Rousseff, had a one-on-one meeting with Obama in reference to this. He said that he would look into it and get back to her, but before he could, more NSA tea was spilled, and it was revealed that the agency had also targeted Petrobras, which is Brazil's state oil company. This led the president to call this new information industrial espionage, and as a result, she called off her scheduled visit to the White House and demanded answers. The called off visit was important because it was to be the first state visit by a Brazilian president in about 2 decades. And although the Obama administration claimed that it was a joint decision made by both presidents, some media outlets described it as the sternest punishment that had been received at that time in response to all of these NSA leaks. This also led Brazil to take a multitude of steps to hopefully get away from the American-run internet.
Number 5, backup. When Glenn...
See? And look how it paused on the screen. I was just about to say, Raymond Reddington has been trying to tell us, man, that there's something going on. You know what I mean? That's why he created the blacklist. That's why he tried to take down the cabal. All that type of stuff like that. He's been trying to tell us, man. Even this dude Snowden, he looked like Tom Keene off the show, don't he? He looked just like Tom Keene. You know, that's what he's giving me, Tom Keene vibes. You know what I mean? But, yo, I'm telling you, that's why I think it's a secret task force out there that we don't know about, that is handling these different things, that is off the record. These people probably don't even exist on record. So it's, I'm telling you, man, watch Blacklist, bro. It makes a lot of stuff like this seem more and more like, yep. And you just sit here and I'll be, yep. I figured.
Ben Greenwald kicked this whole thing off in 2013 with Snowden and his reveals. It was this massive security breach, obviously. Snowden was, of course, in hot water immediately, but he was ahead of the game from the start. See, Snowden had told Greenwald that if anything crazy happens to him, well, he'll just leak even more information. If Snowden was unable to access these encrypted documents on one of his four laptops, that it was set up to automatically send those private documents to higher ups, aka the people directly involved in the leak. On top of that, Snowden reminded The Guardian that he has many, many more secrets to spill, specifically the NSA's surveillance systems. This is why you make backups. Duly noted, Snowden.
In our number four spot today, we have the embassy catastrophe. There was a document from 2007 that was leaked, which named 38 different embassies and missions that were so-called targets of US surveillance. This document didn't quite make it clear whether or not these targets were being looked into by only the NSA, or if the CIA and FBI were also involved. The document described certain things like bugging fax machines with devices that allowed them to listen in on conversation, and the document also listed the names of different programs that are used within the embassies. The document showed that the embassies targeted weren't just those of countries who seemed to be enemies with the United States, and instead included places like India and Mexico, Greece and Turkey. It appears as if the goal was to gain insider information into the diplomatic relations between the targets and the United States. The EU embassy in Washington, D.C. was one of the targets on this document, and this leak had the potential to have jeopardized one of the largest attempted free trade agreements in the world, because shortly after this all came out, negotiations were set to begin between the EU and the United States. The French president at the time made his anger about the situation very public and stated that all future negotiations will only be made under the agreement that the United States cease all unauthorized surveillance of any EU buildings or personnel.
Number three, China. I mentioned earlier that summit where the United States originally wanted to call out China for cyber attacks, but instead Snowden leaked a PowerPoint training slideshow and the tables were turned just like that. Snowden revealed himself as this massive spy kid on June 12th, and he said he was planning on remaining in Hong Kong until he was kicked out. But in his first press interview since coming out with all this information, he informed South China's Morning Post that the NSA was hacking Chinese and Hong Kong computers since back in 2009.
Told y'all he was Tom King. He's able to infiltrate, understand, and just oh my gosh, hold on, man. Look, see stuff popping up on my screen right now. Stuff is popping, like, I'm trying to get through this video. Let me just get through the video, bro. Stuff popping up, like, that I ain't never seen before on my screens and everything, man.
That's a long time ago. That's like when Avatar 1 came out. That's how long ago that was. More specifically, Snowden said that the NSA hacked the Chinese University of Hong Kong, aka the heart of all internet traffic in Hong Kong. Now, of course, this is eye-opening, but there's many who see this hack attack as a good thing. See, citizens want to know what their government's up to, and honestly, I myself would love to know if the NSA was rummaging through my chats. So a poll was conducted on June 10th and 11th, and apparently 44% of Americans were on board with Snowden's outing. They were with him. And 42% of Americans say that he's a bad boy. 57% were not a fan of the NSA's action, while 37% were on board. 30% of folks liked the fact they were being spied on. That's some weird kind of kink. I don't know. What do you guys think? Do you want the NSA in your Dropbox? Let us know in the comments your thoughts below. We'd love to hear from you.
In our number two spot today, we have caller information. In 2013, it was reported by The Guardian that according to the documents that were leaked by Snowden, the Obama administration has allowed the NSA to collect different caller information from Verizon. This was done through what was called a, quote, business records provision of the Patriot Act that was established under the presidency of George W. Bush. It allowed the government to order Verizon to hand over caller information every single day. The information included things like the time, location, and duration of the call. The information began being collected under the Bush administration in 2001, and they were collected from AT&T, Verizon, and Bell South. Of course, once these documents were leaked and the information became public knowledge, US officials began trying to reassure the public that this surveillance was somehow necessary and was actually a program vital to national security, but many people rightfully felt like the spying was an unnecessary invasion of their privacy. This one is tricky because there certainly is a fine line with these things.
And finally, number one, PowerPoint. Nothing sounds less cool than a leaked 41-slide PowerPoint presentation. But when it comes to the NSA, odds are it's gonna be a little juicy. This slideshow is used to train US intelligence, and I gotta say, 41 pages? That's it? I did 45 on medieval knights in high school. Step your game up. This program called PRISM cost about $20 million a year, and it was the highlight of this leak. PRISM kicked off back in 2007. Originally, they partnered with Microsoft, but once they were attached to Apple, come 2012, well, that's when things got a little bit fishy, as most things are with Apple, specifically their maps. That was horrible. The PowerPoint confirmed that the NSA has access to servers belonging to massive tech giants like Google, Skype.
I was just about to look at the names: Microsoft, Google, Yahoo, Facebook, PalTalk, YouTube, Skype, AOL, Apple. We will receive and collect surveillance and store comms. It varies by provider. In general, email, chat, video, voice, videos, photos, stored data, VOIP, file transfers, video conferencing, notifications of target activity logins, etc. You hate to see that on there, etc. That can mean anything. That's that little gray area right there. That's why we put etc. on there, because more stuff we can go get. Online social networking details, special requests.
That the NSA has access to servers belonging to massive tech giants like Google, Skype, or even YouTube. Yeah, right here. They're listening right now. So your search history, emails, anything that rolls through those, usernames, passwords, well, they've got them. Even SkaterBoy69 and Hotmail, odds are they're already looking. You're done. You're canceled, Brad. There was a summit in California, which originally was tense. The United States were accusing China of cyber attacks, but right after Edward leaked this PRISM tea, they didn't have much power at that summit. China and Europe's citizens weren't too pleased here, and honestly, yeah, it's a botched meeting. I can understand why.
Guys, that's our list for today. Make sure you like this video if you liked it. Make sure you subscribe.
Yeah, so I don't know, man. You see what all Facebook went through and all that type of stuff that they had going on and different things. And you at this point, you gotta know, you know, when you sign your phone, sign up for whatever plan or phone you pick up from one of these phone companies, and you don't read that, you know what I mean? The contract that you're signing with these companies, I'm pretty sure it's probably in there. All this type of stuff is taking place, man. They're gonna see it. My advice to people would be just don't be out here doing nothing crazy. don't be out here doing nothing wrong, and you should be fine. You should be fine. You know what I mean? Don't be out here wilding out. Don't do nothing you wouldn't have your problem with your mom seeing. Let's take it back old school. You know what I mean? If your moms wouldn't approve of it, then don't be out here doing it. You won't have much to worry about, all right? So, but y'all get at me in the comment section. Let me know. I finally made it through the video. I didn't think this was going to happen. Maybe it was because of what I was reacting to. I don't know. But I finally made it through. Now I just got to try to get it uploaded. All right. So y'all get at me. Let me know what you thought of this video. And how do you feel about this? Does it scare you? Does it not scare you? How does it make you feel? Let me know in the comment section. All right. It's your boy L. Till the next reaction, I'm gone. Peace.